Hi, this is Michael Orle of MobileBurn.com, and today I have with me the Samsung Haven. It's an easy-to-use, low-cost, entry-level handset that's on sale now for $39.99 with a 2-year contract. So let's open up the box and see what we have inside. Up front and center, the user manual. User manual in English and Spanish. Information about Verizon service, the getting started guide, and some consumer information. Here's the phone itself. You can see it's a very simply designed clamshell. We'll take a better look at it in a little minute. Here's the charger. Pretty small. Micro USB connector, of course. It looks like it comes with a desktop cradle, which is kind of nice. Just looks like you plug in the USB cable here and just slip the phone into the cradle. And just so you can see what it looks like, I dropped it into the cradle just for a moment. Goes in and out quite easily. Seems to charge off of these contacts here on the corner. Take a little bit closer look at them soon. So here's the phone. I've powered it up so you can see the external display. That's a 96 by 96, looks like it's a monochrome display. You can see signal strength, time, and battery power there. Nice striped pattern on the front. On the side of the device, you can see it's about 3/4 of an inch thick. We've got a volume control right here, a 2.5 millimeter headphone jack, so you can't use standard headphones here, and a lanyard fixing point. The whole phone weighs about 3.5 ounces, so it's not super tiny or super light, but perfectly pocketable. This is a port for the micro USB connector if you're not going to use the charging cradle. The cradle makes use of that contact right there, as well as that one there, to charge it easily. Not too much to see on the back of the phone. It has the same kind of pinstriped look as the front, glossy. Solid feeling phone. Let's open it up. You see we've got a 2.2 inch display that has a fairly meager 176 by 220 pixel resolution. It doesn't have great side visibility either. Maybe you can see that dropping away. Keypad's nice and large. Good click on everything. Easy to read, large numerals, very well spaced. I like it a lot. Power and the call, end, and send keys right here. Button for clear. Dedicated speaker button. One for the in case of emergency contacts, and of course two soft keys here for operating the phone. Also a button dedicated to emergency contacts and 911 services. D-pad in the middle has a nice click to it, large OK button in the center. And up at the display you'll see we also have some shortcut buttons. This one here is speaker independent voice dialing.
Welcome to voice recognition by Nuon.
This one takes you to the photo gallery. I guess that has grandparents in mind, since this device doesn't even have a camera on it. And there's also a button for voicemail. So all your most common features are only a button press away, which is kind of nice. I've popped off the rear cover so you can take a look at the battery. The battery is good for 5 hours of talk time or up to 14 days of standby time, according to Verizon. Let's flip open the phone again and see if we can go through the main menu. Very simple menu, vertical list, only a few things on it. Settings. You see we can move left or right to go between the different menus. This is one of the features of the phone. It's the well-being and health section. You've got healing music, supposed to make you feel better. I'm not exactly sure how much healing that's going to do, though. And a fitness trainer and some medical info as well. So you can add notes for, you know, say you're a diabetic or, you know, you have various allergies or things like that that medical personnel might want to know. Jump back to main menu again. We'll go into tools. Just take a look at some of the menus. You can see the voice commands. Tip calculator, world clock, alarm clock, settings. There's the phone number information. My Verizon, contacts. Let's go into the contact list here. You can see we can search by just typing
from any point. So go up here and I'm going to hit the D button so we'll get to directory assistance, for example. Recent call log, messaging, so of course we have voicemail, text messaging. You can create a new message or go to your inbox. Looks like there's no options for email. It's not surprising for a device catering towards the easy-to-use crowd. See if we can drop back into settings. The phone's supposed to have configurable font sizes. And there you go. So you can make the font sizes larger to make them easier to read. You can see that works quite well. So that's my very quick tour of the Samsung Haven, an inexpensive and very easy to use phone for Verizon Wireless. I'm Michael Orle for MobileBurn.com.